linear algebra really is the theoretical or mathematical minimum that you need to be a good computer scientist. So if you ask, why do you want to learn words and grammar and sentences and punctuation and stuff like that? What's the reason for learning it? If you want to be a writer, why not just write rather than learn these things? Without knowing words and sentences and punctuation and stuff, you cannot be a good writer. Similarly, you cannot be a good computer scientist without having the theoretical minimum. If you look at data sets are basically huge matrices. It is not humanly possible for you to look at the numbers and come up with anything sensible out of the data. You'll be writing machine learning programs that make sense out of the data, and that will use linear algebra. For instance, if you look at the formulation of neural networks, it looks like a linear algebra kind of formulation. Neural network is actually a non-linear mapping of one vector to another, and that can be expressed in terms of the jargon and the machinery of linear algebra. Linear regression, as I mentioned earlier, is a straightforward and a beautiful, very elegant application of linear algebra. Statistical ideas like a covariance matrix will turn out to be just a matrix product after doing some initial operations on the matrix. So statistics, some part of statistics, can come out of a linear algebra. Linear regression, which is like a minimization problem, calculus, can also come out of a linear algebra, both in a very elegant and very computationally efficient way. Google PageRank algorithm is basically an eigenvector computation. If you think of the whole network of websites as a connected graph, try to find the dominant eigenvalue and eigenvector, the corresponding eigenvector, that is basically what Google PageRank algorithm is. Beautiful and a very lucrative idea. That is all in computer science or our neck of the woods, but it actually goes beyond that. If you look at quantum mechanics, the mathematical foundation of quantum mechanics is actually linear algebra. It's just that the vectors in quantum mechanics are not column vectors as you see in our context, but they are functions, and dot product is just an integral. And the space where these vectors live is actually called a Hilbert space, is a complex space. But with that kind of qualifications, the rest of it is basically just linear algebra. If you take a look at the mathematics of quantum mechanics, it's identical. There's nothing more to it than that. If you look at Einstein's theory of relativity, the formulation of that also is basically just linear algebra. Later on in this course, we will talk about rotation matrices in three dimensions. Special relativity is basically a rotation in four dimensions, the spatial dimensions x, y, z, and time. It becomes not the normal Euclidean space that you deal with, but it is called a Minkowski space. It's a different kind of space, but the mathematics is the same. Nothing complicated there. The physical interpretations might be complicated. The intuition might be difficult to follow, but the mathematics is actually quite simple. It is also applied in electrical engineering. If Kirchhoff's laws, the conservation of current coming into a node, and Fourier and Laplace transformations, which is slightly more advanced electrical engineering, electronic engineering, filter design, etc. Fourier transformation is basically just a basis transformation. It's a transformation from one basis called the time domain to a different basis, which is called the frequency domain. Fast Fourier transformation is another implementation of Fourier transformation, or basically just linear algebra, and also fairly simple linear algebra like that. Apparently, mechanical engineering also uses it. Control systems theory also does. And I expect these things also use these concepts of linear algebra in a fairly simple way. I think it's computer science that uses the advanced topics in linear algebra. So I spoke so much about linear algebra and its applicability. I hope I motivated and inspired you to be extremely excited about this course. Let's take a step back and ask the question, what's this linearity that appears in the name linear algebra?